night at Broadway. It's fifth Sunday, which means we always try to do something fun and entertaining and different. And tonight is no exception. We've got our Broadway Kids Ministry ready to entertain and to perform and to show off tonight. Is that okay? You know, kids like to show off, so they're going to show off tonight. You guys ready for that? But listen, man, I'm telling you, I'm glad you're here. Welcome to you guys here in the sanctuary. Welcome to you guys Facebook streaming with us tonight. And, of course, welcome to our radio audience tonight as well on KXOX. We're so glad that you are here with us. I have a couple of announcements to make just before we get started tonight. It starts with after the service, fifth Sunday. The fifth Sunday of the summer is meant, and I think this is a Baptist doctrine, you have to have homemade ice cream on the fifth Sunday summer Sunday night. It's just, I think that's right, isn't it? If it's not, we will put that in the church bylaws. But anyway, we'll have homemade ice cream, and there's all kinds of other food. Just hang around, fellowship, have a little snack, or have a big supper. Whatever you feel led to do tonight, we'll leave that up to you and the Holy Spirit. So ice cream fellowship after church tonight. We'll have just a real quick business meeting. We don't have a whole lot to talk about, just a couple of course, you'll get your financial statement, but you'll also hear a little bit about some missionary information that we have for you. And tomorrow night's church softball game is on Field C again. And tomorrow night's game starts at 6:30. Benny, it's at 6:30, which means you need to be there about 6:10, not 6:28. 2 weeks ago, he shows up at 6:28. We had no idea if he was going to be there or not. But he got there. And you know, Benny's that kind of athlete, though. He doesn't need much warming up. I start about 4:30 in the afternoon, warming up a little bit. Actually, you know, on Mondays, that's about what time I get out of bed. It's 4:30 in the afternoon. But anyway, and then as we talked about this morning, we're going to fire back up the men's breakfasts on September the 11th. Now, this men's breakfast will be at 8 o'clock in the morning. We may vary that time a little bit along the way because I hear a few of our younger guys go, we don't get up at that early. All the old guys have been up for 4 or 5 hours by then, but I'm right in between, so I don't know where I fit in. But men's breakfast, starting back up on September the 11th. And something that I mentioned to you this morning and we'll be praying toward now for the next 2 weeks is how we commemorate and remember 9/11. 20-year anniversary this year for 9/11. And so that Sunday, September the 12th, our Sunday morning will be remembering and commemorating the 20th anniversary of 9/11. One more announcement to make, and then it's all kids tonight. So the Wings ladies got together at the August meeting right after I had made the announcement about having two on an emergency type situation, get the air conditioners fixed. And they are fixed, and the Wings ladies had the idea that they would put together a church garage sale. And so that garage sale is going to be on September 25th, Saturday morning, into the early afternoon from 8 until 1. The drop-off time will be that Friday before, on the 24th. So I'll tell you a real funny story real quick. We went to Disney World, I don't know, Abby was like 4 or 5, something like that. So how old were you? Like 11 or 12, somewhere in there. And then Bethany was around 15, 16 years old, something like that. We went to Disney World. And Disney World, you spend money that you don't even know you're spending money. I think when you walk through the gate of Disney World, you lose all sense of everything. And so that's what happened to us. We lost all sense of everything. And I only use American Express. That's just all I've ever done. And so on the way home, on the after we got off the flight and Kim got on her phone and looked at our American Express bill from the Disney World trip, and she almost had a heart attack. And so as we were traveling home from the airport, She told our kids, she said, anything that you haven't worn or played with in the last 2 weeks, bring it to the garage because we got to have a garage sale. We did everything but sell the house and a couple of kids, actually, on that garage sale to pay the American Express bill. And the funny thing about that is, it was quite a ways on up there. Kids brought all their stuff down, and we made exactly the amount of money we needed to make to pay for the American Express bill, and we still had the three kids to spare. So it was really a win-win, I think, after all of that was said and done, and we've got the Disney memory forever now, and the American Express bill was paid. We did make enough points off of that trip to get me a new pair of sunglasses. So that was a real bonus for me. But anyway, garage sales, a lot of fun. We'll have it here at the church. And remember, the air conditioner unit was a little over $6,000 installed. And it is cool in here, thank the Lord. And so we're thankful that it's all done and thankful for what you have already given to help defer that expense that we were not expecting. We were expecting eventually, but just not at this particular moment. So that is something we're very thankful for. Okay, so that garage sale coming up later in the month. Kim will actually be organizing this. She is a garage sale master. And so she'll be organizing it. She is feeling a little bit better. Thank you for your prayers. She's not quite well enough to make it tonight, but a little bit better. And so thank you for your prayers this afternoon for her. And she'll get that all organized and ready to go for that Saturday morning. Let's have a word of prayer. We'll get started tonight. Man, the kids are excited. I'm excited. It's going to be fun to watch our Broadway kids tonight. And Brother Phil, I'll get the fire extinguisher handy. Thank you, Lord, for all that you do for us. Thank you for being such a good, good Father. Thank you for your love and your care and your compassion for us. Thank you for your Son, Jesus, who died on the cross willingly to save us from our sins. Thank you, Lord, for energy, the energy that our kids have. And I just pray you just work through them tonight. Use them and give them a clear mind to say those verses and sing the songs. And thank you so much for Brother Phil, Miss Holly, and the teachers and workers that spend time with them each and every week and love them so much. I thank you for the parents and the grandparents and the friends and neighbors that are here tonight to just celebrate these kids. They're very special to us, and we love them. Thank you so much for this time. Pray you bless it now. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, Brother Phil is on his way. You guys ready? Y'all ready? All right, good. I'm getting the fire extinguisher.
All right. We do again want to thank y'all for being here. Again, I do want to thank all of our teachers and our workers, the ones that that teach and work on Sunday mornings, the ones that teach and work on Wednesday nights, and we couldn't do it without them. And so they play a vital part in the children's ministry. Thank you all as parents and for sending the kids and for the kids to be in here. And we have something that's coming up. I just want to just kind of throw it out there as far as next, starting this Wednesday night. We're going to be doing a little bit of something different with the kids on Wednesday night. We will go for our smaller kids. They will have a classroom all for them for themselves, and they'll have their lesson time and game time and craft time. But for the bigger kids, since I do get a lot of the kids that ask me, well, how did you go and do a trick here? How did you go and do this lesson here or this and stuff? And so what we're going to do is we're going to go, and it's not going to be fire. We won't have them do fire. But we will go and have tables set up. They'll have, for his little goggles, Holly's making lab coats for each one of them. They'll have those. And we'll go and we'll do the lesson. As far as we'll go and we'll do the science experiment. And then we'll apply a gospel application to it. Because if they could go and hear it and do it with their hands as well, studies show that they go and they remember that a lot better. So we're going to be kind of going and doing that. We're excited about that. We're going to go ahead and have the kids. At first, we're going to have all of them come up here and do a, as far as a song. So we go ahead and have the little kids. Oh, come on up here on the stand, on the top row, just right here. All right, just up there at the edge. All right. Kind of just hover. Now the bigger kids, if y'all go ahead and just come stand right behind them. We're going to go ahead and have the bigger kids go ahead and have a seat. And we're going to let the little kids go ahead and stay up. They got a few more songs and verses. All right.
Artillery. I may never zoom. be careful, little eyes, what you see. Oh, be careful, little eyes, what you see. For the Father up above is looking down in love. So be careful, little eyes, what you see. Oh, be careful, little ears, what you hear. Oh, be careful, little ears, what you hear. For the Father up above is looking down in love. So be careful, little ears, what you hear. Oh, be careful, little tongue, what you say. Oh, be careful, little tongue, what you say. For the Father up above is looking down in love. So be careful, little tongue, what you say. Oh, be careful, little hands, what you do. Oh, be careful, little hands, what you do. For the Father up above is looking down in love. So be careful, little hands, what you do. Oh, be careful, little feet, where you go.
All right, we're going to go ahead and have the small kids. They're going to go ahead and go back and sit with their parents. And, you know, go ahead and give them another hand, because it's kind of... So with them practicing, they all did all the emotions. When they get up, when they go and they get up front here on stage, you are a little intimidating and stuff. And so, but no, it's good practice for them to be able, just be able to get up there and get on stage. So we appreciate the things they did. So we'll go ahead and have the explorers.
To all, Lord of heaven and earth. Shout
Let's go ahead and give them a hand as well. Good job, kiddos. Now you go to school tomorrow and tell everybody you sang on the radio. You know, because y'all did. Y'all sang on the radio tonight, and I bet nobody else in your class is going to sit there and say that they sung on the radio. So that's it. So you had that on them. So again, as far as we do want to just share, we are thankful for the opportunity to be able to go and work with the kids. You know what? With the kids, you just never know what's going to happen. What's going to happen next? You know, before I started working with the kids, I used to have a full head of hair. I mean, I have like nice locks like Andrew did, you know, and everything. But, you know, we didn't trade it for nothing. We enjoyed, as far as and all the workers and the teachers that work with the kids, you know, that's something that we go and the Lord has called us to. That's something that we love the kids. We love going and spending time with them and being able to go and teach them, because it is very important as you go and you teach them, get that strong, that foundation that they can go and they can build upon. So we're going to go ahead and look at Daniel chapter 3 tonight for the next few minutes. I'm going to go ahead and get my stuff over here. Go ahead and get it on over here to get so that way it's all ready. I guess I can go ahead and turn that off. All right. Well, Daniel chapter 3, we're going to start off in verse 1. We're going to skip around. It says, Nebuchadnezzar the king made an image of gold whose height was 60 cubits and the breadth thereof 6 cubits. And he set it up in the plain of Dura in the province of Babylon. So here we have King Nebuchadnezzar, and he had made an image of gold. Now, you know when you go and you have something in your head, and you see a vision, this is what it's going to look like when I make it. That's what that was supposed to be. But it kind of looks like something like clown would throw up. But we're going to put our imagination, we're going to imagine that this is King Nebuchadnezzar. He went and he made this image. It's 90 feet tall, and it's made of gold. And so we also know from Daniel chapter 3 that King Nebuchadnezzar said he's going to go. He made the image of gold, and he tells them, he said, I'm going to go, and he calls all the princes, all the governors, all the high officials to it for a dedication of this image. And he goes and he tells us, hey, whenever we go and you hear the name of all the instruments, can y'all make some instrument noises? Okay, that's pretty good enough. When you go and you hear the instrument noises, your job is you're going to go and you are going to bow down and worship this idol. Now, kids, we've talked about for the children of Israel a lot. Can a false idol they hear your prayers? Huh? No. Can they go and can they help you out when you pray? No. And so we also have in our story, we have three Hebrews who were taken as captives, and now they have gone and they have, through the Lord's grace and everything else, and for his blessing, they have made their way up their ranks in Babylon and the Babylonians. And so they went and they were there and they heard about this. They heard about this decree. And with them being Hebrews, them growing up as far as they were young, learning about the Bible, they knew right away from the Ten Commandments that the Bible says you're not supposed to bow down to any other idols except for the one true and living God. So they automatically know this is not, you know, they can't do this. But we also, if we skip down to verse 6, it says, and whoso falleth not down and worshipeth shall the same hour be cast into the midst of a burning fiery furnace. Well, how many of you think that Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego were the three Hebrew guys? How many of you think they want to be thrown into a burning fiery furnace? No. You can imagine. So you got King Nebuchadnezzar saying, whoever doesn't bow down and worship that, whenever he hears the music, it's going to be thrown into the fiery furnace. So what happens? Next thing you know, they go and they start playing the music. Can I get another horn? Anybody? Okay, we had some music. I'm sure it'll be a lot of you. You had the music playing, and everybody bowed down, except for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And you know what? Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, whenever they heard this, they could have sat there and looked at each other and said, do you want to die today? And they would have said, no, I don't want to die today. And so they could have said, you know what? I tell you what. We're just going to make it look like we bowed down. Maybe we'll go and we'll bend down and we'll mess with our sandal. We'll tie our sandal. It will look like we're bowing down, but we're really, we'll make it look like we're worshiping the idol, but we're really not. They could have done that. You know what? They could have sat there and they could have made it look like, you know what? I'm going to go and be like everybody else. You know, that's a problem because if everybody acted like everyone else, there'll be nobody to take a stand. You know, and God causes us to be different. In 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9, I'm going to turn there real fast. In 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9, it says, but ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, an holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. If you're a child of God today, God tells us we need to be different. We're no longer in darkness, but we are in the light. And the Bible says that we should be different. We should be peculiar. That means we're not going to go and be like everyone else. If everybody else is doing something wrong, guess what? We got to make a stand and do what's right. We got to go and people, whenever you go and if you're in a dark room and you go and you see a light, somebody turns on a flashlight, guess what? Your eyes go to that light, doesn't it? As Christians, if we're the light out in a dark world, if people know we're Christians, people are going to be watching us. People are going to be looking at us. We need to make sure we're doing, kind of like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego did, we need to make sure that we are going and we're different. We're standing up to do what's right, even when other people around us are doing wrong. So they played the music, they went and everybody bowed down except for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They stood up. I'm sure they stood up nice and tall. But guess what? Somebody came and tattletaled. Somebody went, the Chaldeans, they went over there to King Nebuchadnezzar and they said, oh, King, live forever. And they said, you remember when you said whoever plays, whenever the music, the band plays, that we are supposed to bow down and whoever does not bow down, they get thrown into a fiery furnace. And the king said, yes, I remember that. I mean, I'm the one that made the law. I'm the one that made the decree. And they said, well, we had three Hebrew children who they didn't sit there and bow down. And so the Bible says that King Nebuchadnezzar, he goes and he summons the trio. He summons them to him. And if we look at verse 17 and 18, King Nebuchadnezzar goes and asks him. And they go and they ask him. Maybe they were like, you know, maybe the king was like, maybe you know what? Maybe you didn't quite understand. We go and we play the music. You're supposed to bow down. Maybe you didn't quite understand. But Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in verse 17 said, if it be so, our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of thy hand, O king. But if not, be it known unto thee, O king, that we will not serve thy gods nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. Then was Nebuchadnezzar full of fury, and the form of his visage was changed to get Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Therefore he spake and commanded that they should heat the furnace one seven times more than it was wont to be heated. Now, whenever the Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego told the king, you know what, king, you can play the music until you're blue in the face, until, you know, it doesn't matter how many times you play, the band plays, we're not going to bow down to your false idol. The Bible says the king did not take that very well. It says his countenance was changed. He was full of fury. If you ask my kids, growing up, they said that when I got really mad, I had a vein that popped out on my forehead. I'm sure King Nebuchadnezzar, his whole face was probably just one big old vein. I'm sure that he was just going. He was just upset. He was full of fury. Then it said that, you know what? Even though the furnace was already hot enough to kill somebody, they said, you know what? Let's go and let's make it seven times hotter. So we're going to go, this is going to be our furnace right here. That being a furnace. We're going to go to how many times? 7 times, so count them out, okay?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
All right. 7 times. So, now, he went, he made it 7 times hotter. I got too much stuff on my hands. We'll try that again here. He went and he made it 7 times hotter. That's why I got to get away from. So now, we had to make it 7 times hotter. It made it 7 times to where, you can imagine too, the guards, the king told his mightiest guards, and said, hey, you know what? I want you to go, and I want you to tie them up, and I want you to throw them into the furnace. And so that's exactly what...
4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay. Now, we have... we have flash paper right here. Now, flash paper is exactly what it says. It goes and it makes a flash. It flashes and it goes away. I mean, there's nothing to it. It just, I mean, it usually flashes a lot faster than that. It's not much of a flash. It just kind of, it makes it, usually it's a little faster than that. Usually what was, like I said, is a flash. So we're going to put Shadrach, I'm going to get 3 pieces of paper, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. We're going to put them in here. And we're going to go ahead and we'll make, for Shadrach, we'll go ahead and make an S. For Meshach, an M. For Abednego, an A. So we got an M for Meshach, an A for Abednego, an S for Shadrach. Now, I want to get this over here just to be keep it away. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they got to go and they got tossed in the fiery furnace. The Bible even says that the fire was so hot that the guards who had Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, the guards who were in, the guards who were in charge of them, who tied them up, they the heat killed them. That was an ultimate fail. Let's try this again. Now. Okay. That was, so the Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and the flash paper, because it gets fire, it burns up. But just like Shadrach and Meshach and Abednego, you still had Shadrach there. You still had Abednego. You still had Meshach. So that tells us, you know, so they didn't get burned up. And that's what it tells us in the Bible. It sits there, and after King Nebuchadnezzar went and threw them into the fiery furnace, and it killed the guards that threw them, it says that the King Nebuchadnezzar, he went, and he started looking there, and he started asking his people, hey, how many people did we go and throw in there? Did we throw in 3 people, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? And the people that he was with, his counselors and things, said, yeah, that was the three Hebrew children. But then he says... there in verse 20, I'm sorry, go ahead and go down to verse 25, and it says, and he answered and said, lo, I see 4 men loose, walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt. And the form of the fourth is like the Son of God. King Nebuchadnezzar, you imagine his surprise. He goes, he looks inside the fiery furnace. Man, he was probably wanting to see Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego being crispy critters, jumping up and around, being full of and being in pain. And it said that whenever he went, He looked in there at the furnace. He not only saw three, but he saw four people. They weren't tied up no more. They were loose. They were walking around. And it said the fourth was like the Son of God. Which also shows, you know what? It isn't in our toughest battles, in our loneliest times, in our times that we think that we have no hope, we also need to remember, too, as Christians, that God is always there with us. That God is we never go through the fires alone. That He's always He's with us each and every time. Not only that, it says that King Nebuchadnezzar, he went and he called out to Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Can you imagine? Any other time, and so it was something about, if you didn't obey the king, you got pretty much a death. We talked about Daniel and the lions then this morning, and Daniel prayed, and guess what? What's the punishment? Get thrown into the den of lions. It was something about, and here, if you go and you disobey the king, you get now, you didn't have lions, but you had the fiery furnace. And I'm sure this wasn't the first time that they had the fiery furnace, but this is also, this is the very first time, though, that King Nebuchadnezzar had to call the people out. Call the people out that were up there just walking around. It says he called Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and they went and they came out. You know what? It said that their coats, their clothes, weren't even singed. That their hairs, mine got singed a little bit, but that their hairs on their hands, on their arms, their head didn't even get singed. They didn't even smell like smoke. They were just in their fire, just walking around in no harm. And so he went, because you imagine that got King Nebuchadnezzar's attention. And right at that time, King Nebuchadnezzar, he went and he made another decree. He said, you know what? Now we know that Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego's God is the one and true and living God. And you know, that just kind of shows us how powerful the God is, how powerful the God that we serve. And guess what? We serve the same God today. And a couple of things that came out of this, the fact that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they were willing to go and to die for God. They were willing to give up their life to do what was right. They said they weren't going to bow down to the idol. They said they knew their God was powerful enough to go and to protect them. But even if it wasn't the Lord's will, they were still willing to give up their life. We can see that. We also think about the witnessing thing. Could you imagine, whenever they didn't bow down at the beginning, and they go and they called out Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and you knew as they were leaving in front of the false idol, and they were walking to go see the king. You can imagine what everybody else was saying. Ooh, man, look at them. They should have bowed down. All they had to do was bow down, and look what. But now, since they didn't bow down, what's it going to do? They're going to die now. All they had to do was bow down. They didn't. But then they go, and word gets back around. Hey, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, remember the ones that were getting thrown into the fiery furnace? They came out unscathed. They came out unburned. They came out, and their God protected them. That right there was another witnessing thing to showing to everybody else in that kingdom that, hey, the one true and living God, God Almighty, He was bigger than Nebuchadnezzar's image of gold. And so as Christians, to wrap things up and everything, as Christians, we got to go and ask ourselves. We serve the same living and true God. We need to go and we need to ask ourselves, first and foremost, have I ever accepted Jesus Christ as my personal Savior? If I have ever asked Him to come to my heart and Savior, if you haven't, then you need to come, you need to make sure you go and you do that. As those that are saved, those even as adults, as long as the Christians, as kids, this story is to speak to all of us about as far as the fact of God needs people to stand up for Him. God needs people to go and to stand in the gap, to stand in the trenches, so to speak, and be able to be there for this world. The world that's in darkness, but God has called us to be lights into the dark world. And that's the great thing about it is that God calls, if you accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior, that we are all lights, that we all have that responsibility, that each and every one of us could do great things for God. It doesn't matter your age. It doesn't matter, you know, what you look like. It doesn't matter how old you are. But God sits there and says, He calls each and every one of us to go and to be a witness to Him. That each and every one of us, if you can look through all through this Bible, this book here that God wrote, and story after story of how God used kids. And if God used kids then, God, we know that God could use kids now. So that's another thing we need to go and remember and allow God to use us. Be willing to stand up for Him. Let's go ahead and go to the Lord in prayer. We'll bow our head. I'll turn it over to brother, to pastor. Let's go ahead and bow our head for prayer. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, again, Lord, we just thank You so much for Your love for us. Thank You so much just for each one of these kids, Lord, who've come and their families have come to Lord, and just what they mean to us, to Lord, and just the opportunity we have to go and invest our time and our lives with them. And Lord, I pray, Lord, just to be with each one of them. Show them as far as about our salvation, dear Lord, and they need to accept You. And those who are saved, Lord, I pray, Lord, just to help this to continue to be a foundation, Lord. Just keep, we keep building on that foundation as they grow stronger, as they go and they give them the faith and the confidence to be like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and stand up for You, dear Lord. Help us to be different. You call us to be peculiar. You call us to be different. And we just ask, Lord, just to help us. Give us the strength and the courage to do so. In Christ's name, amen.
Well, that was super successful. We didn't have to use the fire extinguisher. And I do want to just let you know that Brother Phil's hair is so short this week because of the practice. That's totally kidding. Totally kidding. I've given him cards for my hairdresser so that he doesn't get scalped next time he goes to the barber. But anyway, man, that's fantastic. Kids, man, I tell you what a blessing. And all of you folks that are here representing them and here on their behalf tonight, thank you guys so much for being here. And thank Phil and Holly and our children's workers so much. You guys are just such a blessing. It is such a joy to be able to watch what's going on. Because, you know, I'll be honest with you, I was in a ministry one time where kids were seriously out of sight, out of mind, was the way that the pastor ran the church. In fact, we were working with youth at the time, and the very first time that a kid sat through a big church service was when they sat through it as seventh graders. Yeah. And so guess who taught them how to sit in church? Me and Kim didn't sit together very often because, you know, she's in the middle of the girls, I'm in the middle of the guys, and trying to teach them how to sit through a church service. So that's one thing about our Sunday nights is I think Sunday night needs to be family night at church, and that way, you know, we're here together, and you get to thump your kid on the nose if they need it, or the back of the head if they need it, or whatever, and you teach them how to be in church and to how to act in church because, hey, listen, guys, church needs to be a huge part of our lives, and we are so thankful that it is here at Broadway, and we are so thankful that you guys are here tonight. Your kids did great, man, I'm telling you. Those little bitty ones, man, you could tell they wanted to sing, but they were scared to death of you guys. You just tell. They were frightened. My little granddaughter, I've never seen her that quiet, or that still, for that matter. I was like, wow, that is something. I'm pretty impressed by that. Now we know how to take all that fiery stuff out of her. But listen, I tell you what, I was just kind of sitting there thinking as thinking about everybody that's here tonight, and I do have copies of the financial report. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put those on the back. This is just your personal FYI, what's going on in the finances for July. And I just want, as far as a business meeting is concerned tonight, I do need to tell you of a couple of things that have happened and talk to you just real quick about a couple of missionaries. First of all, missionary Jeff Price, he is in Bolivia. Actually, he's not in Bolivia right now because he's on furlough, and he will actually be here in our services on October the 3rd. And so he'll be reporting in on October the 3rd, so he'll be here that Sunday night. And we have had in the past month two more missionaries come off the field. And so I told Holly the other day that I want her, she's getting me a list